Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Here in Corvallis, Oregon, is Reeser Stadium, the battlefield for this game. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 27-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Nice run there as they work the outside.
That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He's on the run. And he's taken down at the 49.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 49. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
Throws out and through his hands. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. He launches one for the end zone. Incomplete.
The deflection prevented them from getting any yards, and now it's fourth down.
Quinn wants to pin these guys deep, and you got to think he'll be looking coffin corner on this one. And he has it on the corner. He's out to the 30. He's pushed out of bounds at the 34. The Beavers know that they can give this guy the ball, Kirk, 25, 30 times a game, and that's great. And if it's working, that's perfect. But also, as a defensive team, you look at him and you go, we worry about him too much, we could get burned somewhere else.
Well, the defensive coach has told us this week the first thing that they have to do is stop this running game. And when you're convinced you have to stop the running game, you leave your defensive backs, especially your corners, isolated one-on-one in coverage. And if they're smart, they'll try to take advantage of that and try to make some big plays in the passing game, maybe early, and then go back to old reliable, and that's running the football.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on their own 31. Quick out to his receiver.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker.
5-56, 5-56.
Tackle right around the 40. An incredible series for the defense, and they get him out after three plays.
That offense has to regroup and come up with a plan to move the ball down the field next time.
Langford is the punter. Tackle at the 31-yard line. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for sides to come out with some urgency. to the 40. He's knocked down of bounds at the 48. 17 yards. First down. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 48. Run to the outside.
That's good for a gain of a couple of yards. That brings him second and five.
Dumps it complete the tight end over the middle. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. And he's tackled at the 36-yard line.
Terrific execution by the entire offense to make that run work and to get the third down conversion.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 36. Nice run up the middle.
That makes it 33.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. Tackle made at the 21-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. We've played one quarter. Still no score. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. And down he goes at the 20-yard line. From the 20-yard line, second down. Tackles him hard at the 27. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
That makes it fourth and one.
North Carolina State could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away, and he got it.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
3-0, North Carolina State. Roberson looks ready to kick this one off. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And he shoved out of bounds at the 35. From their own 35-yard line. First down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Brought down around the 39-yard line.
Second and six.
Right and left, right and left. Go down. Mike 56.
And he's leveled the 47-yard line. From their own 47-yard line. First down. The tailback. He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
That brings him second and nine.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's tackled in the open field. From the 39-yard line, it's first down. They bring the quarterback down.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
4 down. 87's getting the ball. 87's getting the ball. Mike 56.
That's a great tackle at the 31. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Four down. Mike 56. Ready.
Harris up the gut. Nice run there. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really a nice read.
First and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. It to the end zone. He caught it for the touchdown. And he adds the extra point. A nice 9-play, 76-yard drive. They put up 7 points.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and receiver.
So the score now, 7-3. Oregon State lines up for the kickoff. Fowler has it at the 5. Tackle made at the 22-yard line. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well. One thing to have great defense, it's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Second down and 7. Ball on their own 25. Quick throw out to the receiver.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Stop around the 47-yard line.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
From the 47-yard line, first down. He scrambled. He's tackled at the 35-yard line.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks. This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he hits the PAT. A six-play, 79-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. The score now, 10-7. Roberson gets set to kick this one away. And he has it on the corner. He's to the 20. And they push him out at the 24-yard line.
Oregon State's coaching staff, I've got a thing going into halftime, and we're getting right now, Kirk. They've got to do something different. What they had planned with their star running back's just not working today.
Well, I think the continuity between a coaching staff and a quarterback and an offense is tested. Their star player is not having a great game. They're losing this football game. I think now, as we're close to this half, now's when you start to think about what other ways can we attack this defense. And then maybe eventually we get back to our star running back. But in the meantime, let's try to find some other ways to attack and be able to put points up.
From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. We've played a half. The Wolfpack lead 10-7. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 28-yard line.
Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. It just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
1 yard loss for the halfback.
That is a loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. Wants to go long and done. And he's taken down right around the 36-yard line. So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. His way to about the 20. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 19-yard line.
Ready?
Toss left, taken down behind the line. To a receiver, touchdown.
They look awesome on that play. A well-thrown football and a great effort to get the ball into the end zone.
He makes the PAT. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
A great scene in Austin. And for Texas, we've got a little drama starting to unfold right now. A potential major upset in the making. And for Archie, he's caught one for a touchdown. The Buckeyes have the lead, 7-3.
We're at 14-10 in this one, Reese. Oregon State kicked this one off. Francis takes it at the 4. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Quick pass.
It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
Second and 8. Ball on their own 31. He's to the 40. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line.
Jefferson's the intended receiver on the play. First down.
From the 46-yard line. First down. Now he's scrambling. He's taken down at the 44-yard line. Yardage on that run.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. And he's tackled at the 24.
A part of any quarterback's arsenal should be the ability to sell the run with a good fake. He does a really good job here on the fake, and then they pick up some nice yards.
Man left, man left. Three down.
And down he goes at about the 13.
Peterson's on the tackle at the 13-yard line. That makes it
from the 13-yard line. It's 1st down. Tackle at the 11. A yard, maybe 2 on the carry.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Play fake and looking to run. Tackle made around the 3-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it 1st and 2.
1st and goal from the 2, and they can smell the end zone. Everybody bunched up tight defensively. Right down, right around the
2-yard line.
And he gets a yard on the run.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Touchdown, North Carolina.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point.
And he tacks on the extra point. North Carolina State is lining up to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. At the 30. He's tackled at the 37-yard line.
Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. Be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half. The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
Ready! Green 90! Green 90!
Gets out to around the 48.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
From their own 48-yard line, first down. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. NC State's got a 3-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four.
Down 10 yards to go. Ball on the 40. As a man, he'll lose big yards.
That is a loss of five. That'll bring up second and 15.
Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on the 45.
Let's go!
Quick throw. Good tackle there in space. Pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
From the 25-yard line, second down. Tack on any yardage. He fights forwards about the team.
When you get in these third down situations, a confident offense expects to get the yardage they need on the ground. It's a good job by the defense to shut that down.
They'll line it up for the field goal.
Just under three to go in regulation.
He gets it up,
and the field goal is good. Langford has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off.
He's to the 20. Tackle at the 23.
Let's see what they can do on offense as they take possession after the return.
At the very least, they've got to get in the field goal range. Once they've done that, they can think about taking a few shots into the end zone.
We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation.
And they make the stop at the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of 15 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
It's first and 10.
Ball on their own 38. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long.
He lets it go. Complete. He's tackled
around the 31-yard line.
First down.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. Just under two to go in the game. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
It to the 14.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
From the 14-yard line, first down. We're going to overtime. So it looks like four quarters wasn't enough. We're heading to overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime.
Mike 56, Mike 56. Ready, green 19.
Fires it out.
He's real at the 13-yard line.
From the 13-yard line, it's first down.
He steps up, fires quickly, touchdown!
Well, that's how you want to start off an overtime period, to put the touchdown on the board and put the pressure now on them. They know they've got to match this touchdown if they want to stay alive.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
The Volunteer Navy has arrived. Tennessee set to run through the tee in Knoxville. The Volunteers relentless with their rushing attack, and they score a touchdown. Washington's ability in the passing game is completely evident, already with a touchdown pass. Tennessee leads it 14-0. Meanwhile, the Tigers were ranked 18th. They hope this victory will push them even higher. And for Missouri, they start the season with a victory. Missouri puts it away and wins by 20.
I don't expect that that score is going to hold, but boy, that would be an upset. From the 25-yard line, first down. Fires right side, got his tailback, and he's taken down at the 25. And they need to get it to the 15. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's knocked out of bounds around the 6-yard line. Second and goal. Ball on the 10. Robinson fakes the handoff. What's on a move? Touchdown. So they come up with the equalizer.
This offense did just what they had to do. They knew they needed 6 points, and they got it. That was just a great series.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point.
Well, it's going to take another round at least. You can bet the coaches are going to look to be more aggressive on both sides of the ball.
First and 10. Ball on the 25. In and hit immediately for a loss. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
He's going to try and scramble. There's a missed tackle. They'll bring him down right around the 26-yard line. From the 26-yard line, third down. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
It's up, looks long enough, and he got it. From the 25-yard line, first down.
Here we go. Green nine.
to his receiver.
This one is over.
This one's in the books, and our final score, Oregon State 30, North Carolina State 27. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.